Dear Liz Lavero, as it is your birthday, we have decided that instead of you doling out wise advice to the needy members of society, we're going to reciprocate and give you your own advice. Like, you shouldn't have to be naked to be strong.
Wait, what does that have to do with taking shots?
Can you please read the fucking motherfucking question? We've all screwed a lizard.
You're obviously not the only person who feels this way. I mean, this is pretty much the most ubiquitous question. I think it's on every woman's mind. I mean,
but instead of sort of like compromising your standards and thinking like, all right, I'm gonna date the next like ape that wanders in my direction, you kind of have to realize that sometimes you gotta just like climb the vines with a few apes, and eventually you're gonna meet someone that's not an ape, or at least they're a very evolved ape. So a lot of women have this idea that you need to go for a guy who has large assets. I think that it's important sometimes to look for the guys who have the little sticks. Sometimes you have to just bust your balls. Even if you don't have balls, which I don't. You just have to bust your balls and go out there and just like find what you want. Like, do you want to be a rock star? Do you want a taco? You need to Google like where are the best tacos in Brooklyn. Like,
you can't Google the best person to date though.
You can go on Facebook. Let's get past. Don't be above internet dating.
Gay people do it all the time. Hey, you would know.
I'm gay. It's okay to meet people on the internet. They're an internet persona with an internet name. They're still a real human with a body.
Okay.
Go to parties where you don't know anyone.
Half the time?
Sean does it. I do. Sean goes to parties where she doesn't know any. She's not even invited. She's like, let me in, motherfuckers. And then she has a great time. Talk to guys at bars.
That's not really ever worked for me except when I'm with you. Bring May.
I'm May. You can pay me if you want. It's sort of a service. Anyway, yeah, talking to guys at bars is really good because, like, they're drunk, so they'll have sex with you. Crash your crushes. If you're like, if you like somebody, find out where they're gonna be and go there.
Everybody does it, we just don't admit it.
That's just what you do. You just follow your crushes everywhere, and until they get a restraining order, you should just have fun. Should we talk about being let down? We should, because it really hurts. It hurts. Is it worth it, like, going after something that you want if that person is going to let you down in the end?
To pretend that love doesn't matter is stupid.
And we're just like, oh.
Yeah, you have to fucking embarrass yourself.
Yeah, you totally have to embarrass yourself.
Welcome to love.
And love is embarrassing.
Own your feelings and don't play games. I don't think you need any more elaboration than that. I feel like we all get so used to having to pretend that, you know, that that's just like the domain of romantic comedy.
So real people have feelings too? Not just Meg Ryan?
Exactly.
So you're saying that we're all Meg Ryan?
I'm Meg Ryan.
You're Meg Ryan. And some of us are...
Billy Bob Thornton.
As Aaliyah said... Aaliyah said, if at first you don't succeed, dust your ass off.
Dust his ass.
She did die, but not. She did not die because she brushed her ass off and tried again. She died because
she got in a small plane.
Small plane accident. But before she died, she had a lot of sex. So,